Pudding, you're from Indonesia, right? I'm born there. So, do you support any Indonesian football team?
No.
None of them?
Yeah, like Jakarta or Bandung, Surabaya, anything?
Nope.
Well, I'm from Indonesian descent, so this rivalry is totally new for me too. I live in the Netherlands, but I've been born there. Let's go to the other side of the world, to the Indonesian archipelago, to Java to be exact. This is the old Indonesian derby, the classic between Persib Bandung versus Persija Jakarta. Welcome to Rivalries Around the World, I'm Jeroen Boedi. Technically, it is not a derby, but it's a rivalry. And yes, it's also the name of the show, so it's Rivalries Around the World. The Old Indonesian Derby, or Derby Indonesia in Indonesian language, is one of the bitter and fierce rivalries in the Southeast Asia region. A great football history between Indonesia's biggest teams, not necessarily the most successful teams. In the past 20 years, it turns really ugly. Let's go to the stadium, shall we? Persib Bandung is from Bandung. Bandung is the third largest city in Indonesia and is the second largest city in West Java metropolitan area. Bandung, the numbers aren't fixed, is around 4 up to 7 million people. Persib ground is the Galoa Bandung Lautan Api Stadium. If you translate it, it's called the Bandung Sea of Fire Sports Arena Stadium. It has a capacity of 38,000 seats. Following the highway northwest, 3 hours by car, well, if you don't have a traffic jam, I experienced to sit in the car for 3 hours, going from south to North Jakarta, and that is just 15 kilometers. Anyway, Persija's ground is south of the Indonesian capital. The Gelora Bung Karno main stadium has a capacity of 70,000. It is also the national stadium of the Indonesian national football team. The stadium is named after the first president of Indonesia, Soekarno, or for French, Bung Karno. It should be really impressive when in the 80s there was a record attendance of under 50,000 spectators during the Persib Bandung vs Medan game. What about the teams? First, Persija. Persija Jakarta is founded on November 1928 as Voetbalbond Indonesisch Jakarta or Football Association Jakarta. And later it changed their name into the official name Persatuan Sepak Bola Indonesia Jakarta, or Persija for short. Not sure Persia named after the Persians and the Persian Empire, because Indonesia has the largest dense population of Islamic believers. The nickname of Persija is the Makan Kamayoran, or Kemayoran Tigers. The crest of Persija Jakarta is round. In the middle, there's a label and the coat of arms of nowadays Jakarta. And in the middle, the independence statue. On top is the motto of Jakarta,
Jaya.
Jaya.
That means prosper and grace. On top of the label, there's the name in red, and behind the label, 5 red stripes. The kit's original colors are orange with red, but they changed those colors in red and white, the colors of Jakarta. In 1997, because of the decision by the Jakarta governor, yes, a governor, not chairman, or the fans, the away kit is white. The fans of Persija regularly wear the orange color to identify themselves. It is the most successful football club in Indonesian football. On domestic level, they won the national title 11 times, and one time they won the national cup. International, they compete several times in the AFC Champions League and the AFC Cup, but never reached the quarter or semi-finals. Some famous players of Persija is Emmanuel Kenmonge and Martin Funk. So let's go into Persija. The official name is Persatuan Sepak Bola Indonesia Bandung, founded on March 14, 1933, as Bandung Inlandse Voetbalbond or Bandung Domestic Football Association. It is a merger between several associations and clubs, Persatuan Sepak Bola Indonesia Bandung, and teams affiliated with the National Football Association. Nicknames of Persib Bandung is Muang Bandung, the Bandung Tiger, and Pangeran Biru, the Blue Prince. The crest of Persib Bandung is similar with the seal of Bandung. Persib's logo is taken from the symbol plus the numbers 1933 and Persib's writing. The logo is a heart-shaped shield. The shield is divided into two parts, separated, girder, the horizontal black color, and as much as four. The philosophy of the shield or armor in the logo symbolizes the struggle to achieve a goal, to use a shield to protect themselves. In the addition, the shield has the meaning ensured all sorts of danger and difficulties. The colors in the logo are yellow, means wealth and nobleness. Black is a sturdy, upright and strong. Green means prosperity and cool. White is a symbol of purity and faithfulness, meaningful blue. Currently our Persib logo plus images of two stars as a sign, Muang Mandung has won the league championship twice, namely in 1995 and 2014. The club's colors are officially blue and white according to its statute, and it is used by the fans. The combination Biru Bodas, blue and white, in their songs and chants. These were the colors of the Silawangi Kingdom. The club's original badge was implemented in 1996, consisting of the team's name, Persib Bandung, above the logo of the Bandung government. The club's honors: they won the national championship 7 times and 1 presidential cup, the National Cup. The international highest achievement is reaching the quarterfinals in 1995 of the Asian Club and 1 appearance in the AFC Cup. So some notable players are Michael Essien, Carlton Cole, Sergio van Dijk, Rafael Maitimo and Shohei Matsunaga. So what about the rivalry? This is classic capital versus the rest of the country rivalry. This is not new, however, this is the capital versus the second largest city on West Java. Technically, Bandung counted in the urban metropolitan area as one entity with Jakarta. But it is not being only from the capital is automatically the enemy. People from Bandung are from an ethnic Sundanese people group. Sundanese, Hinduist influenced, are the second largest minority group, 40 million, after the Javanese. The majority of the Javanese has an Islamic background with an amount of 95 million. Javanese are mostly located in the area of Jakarta. Japanese people are highly influenced in the Indonesian language and the political positions, and influence from the capital. Religiously and culturally representing each other, minority group turns much as your eye can see. The fanatic fans you have on both sides, Persib Bandung fans as a whole, call themselves the Boboto. And within the Boboto there are several groups like the Flavocito Casuals, Bomber and the famous of all, the Viking Persib Club. The Vikings are the oldest fan-based group in Indonesia and is established in 1993. The fans of Jakarta called the Jackmania and is established in 1997. Up to the 2000s, the matches are friendly but took a nasty turn and things get really messy. It became violent. One of the reasons sets the fuse in the 90s and the 2000s when the renewed reforms were introduced to make the Indonesian league more appealing. But those matches were a source of corruption, strange decisions and local government affairs. Especially the last one, FIFA banned Indonesia from the international stage in 2015 due to poor governing, mismanagement and organizing the league and failing to control the violent incident. Also, within the Indonesian league itself, the FIFA asked them not to play the league anymore in different levels, in different tiers. It became a breeding ground of a less friendly fans from both sides. Riots broke out regularly. For example, in 1999, Persib fans visited Jakarta, but the fans weren't given any proper place or seats to view the match, so the crowd started tearing everything apart and fighting the police. During the economic backdrop in the 2000s, fans of the ghetto and the poorer areas of both cities started getting together and going to the league games. It sets off a chain of incidents. It is a common problem because most of the fans can't afford a ticket that is around 45,000 Indonesian rupiahs, but an average wage is 50,000 a month. And the majority of the people in those violent incidents aren't members of the ticket holders of the clubs. This system should filter the better fans going to the game, but those fans go up anyway and hope managing a way into the stadium. During those violent clashes, even without football, but simply being at the wrong time on the wrong spot in the wrong colors is reason enough beating to someone dead. From 1993 so far there are 76 football related deaths in the Indonesian football. Just the last couple of years so far, 7 deaths is by this rivalry alone. But banning the fans or play the home games elsewhere or behind closed doors somehow, the authorities doesn't have any grip to contain the problem due to banning orders or CCTV because lack of money or priorities of the government or failed crowd management. Clash between fans still happens when busloads of fans coming back from a home game 500 km away and by accident passed by the opposing fans, what immediately sets the spark. Also, the security forces has a hand in escalating the violence. A small war on the stands can escalate when the white police decide suddenly fire tear gas canisters into the stands, and more fans turn against the people. This has also another downside. A lot of innocent fans are arrested, while the local authorities don't know what is really going on. When the fans from both sides show up without a ticket due to safety reasons, the police decide to open the doors after halftime by failed crowd management. People get injured or the police try to contain the disturbance by using excessive force. And also a lot of innocent people getting arrested and go behind bars for a very long time while they were just simply in the wrong place at the wrong time. So everything what happened in the 70s and 80s in Europe, it started happening now in Indonesia. But now there are no solutions, and move the match to another island won't help to reduce the violence. However, fans can stand each other. There were a lot of players play for both teams, like Rafael Maitimo, Budiman Yunus and Mohamed Ilam. Hopefully, the majority of the fans look at those players if they move to the other team without being threatened. Why can't both fans accept each other? I know it is a rivalry, but somehow you have to draw a line somewhere to take it to a really different, violent level. What about head to head, those two teams? Almost 100 matches has been played between Persib and Persia, but those numbers are from the 50s of the 20th century. During the Persiri Kattan period, the National Amateur League, soon after Indonesian independence, the league wasn't held in the war years and the war for independence. But the rivalry goes way back in the 1930s. As soon as Persib Bandung was founded, they immediately became second in 1933 national championship. And a year later, Persia became first and Bandung became second again. That changed in 1937 when Bandung won the national title. So from 1951, both teams met almost 100 times. It is nearly even just a couple of winning games made the difference between Persia, 33 game win, and Persib win 30 times. 35 times the games end up in a draw. So the largest victory by Persib was 7-0 on Persia in 1976. Persia's big win was in 1951 by winning 7-2. Final whistle. In conclusion, a rivalry of big proportions with a lot of history and great stories, from the Dutch colonial times up to the Liga 1. Both teams are very proud to being the best team on Java and Indonesia and want to claim the bragging rights. I hope for the better the authorities, the Indonesian FA, the fans, use common sense to reduce the violence, especially when Indonesia is planning to organize the Olympics, World Cup or Asian Cup. I hope they have a master plan. Still, if you are planning to visit one of these clubs, go visit the game but use common sense and try to enjoy the game, like the majority of the people in the stadium. A rivalry shouldn't be in the spotlight of violence, but of enlightenment of Indonesian football, and should be a huge event and party. This was this episode about the old Indonesian derby. Let me know what you think about this Indonesian derby, post them below in comments. And thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. And let me know what kind of unknown football derby or rivalry I should talk about nobody's heard of. Okay, see you at the next rivalry. Bye bye.